Good morning, friends.
Good morning, friends.
Welcome to this Mass. This Mass will find pray for Rosemary and all the other patients that we have. And we celebrate the feast of St. Matthew, Apostle and an Evangelist. Go and make disciples of all nations, baptize them and teach them to observe all that I have commanded you, says the Lord. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's reflect, acknowledge our sins and ask for forgiveness as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You are said to be the portrait of our Lord. Sitting at the customs post, he said to him,
"Follow me." And he got up and followed him. While he was at table in his house, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat with Jesus and his disciples. The Pharisees saw this and said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" He answered this and said, "Those who are well do not need a physician, but the sick do. Go and learn the meaning of the words, I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Who could society today think to be the worst sinners of earth? Beyond redemption. We are in a group that people think that group is beyond redemption. I think society has become of age. But that doesn't mean people don't think like that. If we are genuine with ourselves, we may find people we don't like to associate with, people we think they are more sinful than anyone else. In fact, the Pope just told us we are wasting a lot of time on groups of people, talking, castigating them, and we are failing in the work of compassion and mercy. We are spending all our time thinking and talking about gays, talking about abortion, and we have forgotten that the work of the church is compassion and mercy. In fact, the Pope says, when he was asked the question about gays, about abortion, he was asked, "What do you think about it?" He said himself has been criticized for saying very little about it. And he goes further to say, he doesn't have to say about anything about them. And he answered the question with a question. If God met with a gay, if God met with someone who has committed abortion, what would God do? Or how would God see that person? God will not spend time about that one action. You'd see the person in the eyes. Notice, you'd see the person. Not the simple act. You'd look at the person with compassion and mercy. That is the work of the church. To look at people with compassion and mercy. We spend through, as he says, we have become a church of bureaucracy, a church of law, and I like the beautiful expression that he puts. We have made confessionals at torture chambers. Beautiful, which is very true. People don't go to confession anymore because we have reduced confession, we have made confession torture chambers. But what is our reading telling us today? Before we come to read the reading we have in Matthew chapter 9, we have been reading a number of things. One, we have read about Jesus cleansing the leper. We have read about Jesus healing the centurion's servant. Jesus healing Peter's mother-in-law. Jesus calming the storm, healing the paralytic. Oh, we have heard quite a number of things before we hear about the conversion of the tax collector, Matthew. This is in the same gospel that Matthew has written, the gospel of Matthew. Why do we have that chronological and the of our setting of those events before the conversion of the tax collector? We hear these stories, we hear about this call after all this because the call of a tax collector into the apostle. Indeed, the conversion of a single person is equally a miracle. It's a miracle done by Jesus. Just like coming, cleaning the leper, just as calming the storm, just as healing a paralytic, the call, the conversion of an individual is equally a miracle that God performs. And who can perform this miracle? Only Jesus can perform the miracle of calling an individual into his kingdom. Sometimes we pretend it is the work of me living. This is the work of Jesus Christ. To change the heart of men and women is the work of Jesus Christ. How does he do it? In our case today, he does it in two simple words. Follow me. And the miracle is performed. Follow me. But is it possible that Jesus can say, follow me, and we don't do anything? Jesus tells us we have to open our minds to these words of following. If our mind is closed, we just come to church to see and complete a ritual. Just as the Pope is telling us, the follow me cannot act, cannot perform the miracle that Jesus wants. He performs the miracle by simple words, follow. And finally, there is something that is impossible in this miracle. It's an instantaneous following of Matthew to Jesus. It's psychologically not understandable how someone can say, follow me, and we do. We don't act like that. Human beings don't act like that. What does that tell us? It tells us that men live under prior knowledge of Jesus. That even before we are converted, our hearts, our lives start to move towards Jesus and his mission through very different means. Long before we are born, long before the miracle occurs, Jesus, somehow, some things happen, and we start to have a heart and a mind that is prepared for God. We pray that we may have an open mind and heart for the conversion, and especially for the conversion of our own souls and minds to the true following of Jesus. Let us rise to offer our prayers to God as we pray for the time of rest. Of Rosemary, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear me.
We pray for ourselves that we may have an open mind and heart when we exercise, when we celebrate our religion, that our hearts, our minds may be ready to hear the words of Jesus. Follow me. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear me.
Let us pray for our church, that you may be a church of mercy and compassion, not a church of laws and regulations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear me.
What else we pray for?
For people
who
be anti-violence
to
the
legislation of
the Lord.
Lord, hear me.
Lord,
hear me. For all our intended earth and Lord.
Lord, hear me. Let us pray and thank the Lord for the gift of St. Matthew, that he may intercede for us. He may be an example to us, so that always and everywhere, converted and called, we may become apostles, disciples of Jesus. We bring all this to Jesus, who is our Lord and Savior, forever and ever.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread we offer, fruit of the heart and the work of human hands, to become for us the bread of God.
Blessed be the Lord forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, we are united with the divinity of the one who God himself, and united with our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer, fruit of the wine and the work of human hands, to become for us the spiritual drink.
Blessed be the Lord forever.
Without the spirit and the God at heart, we will be accepted by you, Lord, and we are sacrificing yourself this day.
As we celebrate and kneel the memorial of St. Matthew,
Now and always, always, is on board. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call the Son of the Lamb.
Glory.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternity.
Amen.